This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to solve this inequality, x cubed minus 3x squared is less than 6 minus 8. This is a more advanced problem that you should probably know some pre-calculus, or at least some college algebra before doing it, because you'll need to have knowledge of the rational root theorem. All right, so here's the problem. X cubed minus 3x squared is less than 6x minus 8. So remember, our first step is to get 0 on one side. So I'm going to subtract 6x and add 8 to both sides. So we still have less than 0. And now we need to factor the left-hand side. As it turns out, we have four terms, so you might try factoring by grouping, but it will not work. So for instance, if I took the first two terms and I factored out an x squared, and I took the second two terms and let's say factored out at minus 2, we'd have 3x minus 4, but these aren't common factors. So you could try all sorts of things, but you won't get anywhere trying to factor this by grouping. So you need to use another method of factoring this. So I'm going to use the rational root theorem, and I'm going to do that on a separate page, and then we'll come back and we'll put our factors here. But if you have something cubed, usually it's going to be three factors. Okay, unless one of, well, it will be three factors, but sometimes you'll have the same factor, so something squared. So we're going to try to factor this. And I'm going to find the roots. In other words, I'm going to see what makes those equal to 0. Because basically, after we factor, we set each factor equal to 0 anyway. So I'm going to go ahead instead and just write equals 0. And I'm going to use the rational root theorem, which means the possible rational roots are factors of the last term right here, 8. Over the factors of the coefficient of the first term, right, which is 1. So basically that could be plus or minus 1, 2, 4, or 8. All right, so what does that mean? If 1 is a root, if x equals 1, that means x minus 1 would be a factor, basically. So you could either do long division, or you could do synthetic division to figure this out. So I'm going to use synthetic division. So I'm going to plug in 1. So we also need to know synthetic division to do this method. If you don't want to do long division, let's see, that's 1. And 1 times 1 is, goes up here is 1. Add, that's negative 2. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. Negative 6 plus negative 2 is negative 8. 1 times negative 8 is negative 8. Add, you get 0. So you know what? 1 was one of the roots. So this tells us x minus 1 was one of the factors, because we have a remainder of 0. So this problem now is really x minus 1 times, well, what's left? These are the coefficients of the polynomial that's left, which is x squared minus 2x minus 8. And now this can be factored. So I have x minus 1 times x minus 4 times x plus 2, and those are the factors we want. So now we're going to go back to the problem. This is all scratch work. This, you might figure out this factorization a totally different way that I've just shown you. You might have plugged in 4. You might have done long division with x minus 1. I'm not going to show you all the different ways, but what was kind of convenient is the first possible rational root worked, plugging in 1. That was nice and convenient. So here we're back to our original problem. We're putting in those factors. And then remember, you want to set each factor equal to 0 to get the critical points. And so x minus 1 equals 0 means that x is 1. X minus 4 is 0 means that x is 4. X plus 2 equals 0 means that x is negative 2. These are our critical points. Now notice what we have here is less than, so it doesn't say that the left side could be equal to 0. So if you put in 1, notice you'd have 0 times something, and 0 is not less than 0. So these are not solutions. So when I draw my number line and put these numbers on, let's say negative 2, you know that's 1, let's say that's 4. These are not solutions, so you're going to put a circle as opposed to a dot. All right, now this breaks up the graph into 4 regions. Numbers less than negative 2, in between negative 2 and 1, in between 1 and 4, and greater than 4. So let's pick a number less than negative 2, and we're going to plug that into, remember, we're going to plug it into here and just decide whether each of those factors is positive or negative. All right, so how about we're going to test x equals, let's say, I need more room here. We're just going to try, how about x equals negative 5. Okay, so in the first factor, negative 5 minus 1, that's a negative number, right? Negative 5 minus 4, the next factor, that's another negative number. And negative 5 plus 2, that's also a negative number. Negative times negative times negative is positive. So it's positive in this region. If you try any a number less than negative 2, and it doesn't matter, you could have plugged it into this original problem, but just notice you'd have to actually plug in negative 5 and do those computations on both sides of the equation. See if it's true or not. All right, let's pick a number in between negative 2 and 1. Zero's in there. I always try 0 if I can, wherever that is. So I'm going to try 0. So in the first parentheses, the first factor, if I put in 0, that's negative. When I plug in 0, because 0 minus 1, 0 minus 4, that's also a negative number. And 0 plus 2, that's a positive number. Negative times positive is positive. All right, we want to pick something in between 1 and 4. So how about we try 3? All right, so we're going to plug in 3 into x minus 1. That's positive. 3 into into x minus 4. 3 minus 4 is a negative number. And 3 plus 2 is 5. So it's positive. Positive times positive is negative. And the last one, pick a number bigger than 4. Let's try 10. You can pick any number you want bigger than 4. All right, so if we're going to plug in 10 minus 1, 10 minus 4, 10 plus 2, all those are going to be positive. You end up with positive times positive, and that's positive. Now here's something you may have noticed when you're looking at these intervals. Oops, what did I do here? This first one, I said negative and I wrote positive. Okay, negative. You might notice that it seems to alternate. It goes negative, positive. And actually, it does usually do that as long as you don't, if you only have linear factors. In other words, if you don't have some factor squared or some factor to the fourth power. So that what usually does happen, they'll alternate. Okay. In fact, they will always alternate if that's the case, if it doesn't have any squared term or fourth term, any even exponent. Okay, so we want where it's less than 0. So we went over here. That's where it's negative. And in between here, it's the other place where it's negative. So if we're going to write this in interval notation, all right, so it goes from a negative infinity up to 2, and it doesn't include 2. So we have this union, this next part, which is between 1 and 4. Remember, that's not an ordered pair, right? That's an interval, all the numbers between 1 and 4.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.